हमें बचपन से बताया जाता है कि बिजनेस करना इज़ फॉर बड़े लोग, बिजनेसमैन अमीर होते हैं, एंड वी आर ऑलवेज टोल्ड दैट जो एम्प्लॉय होते हैं वो गरीब होते हैं, एंड दैट इज़ वेरी वेरी ट्रू, बट स्टिल एवरीबडी ट्रेन्स फॉर बिकमिंग एन एम्प्लॉय एंड नोबडी ट्रेन्स फॉर बिकमिंग अ बिजनेसमैन। हेलो एवरीवन, माय नेम इज अनुज, आई एम अ सेकंड ईयर एमबीबीएस स्टूडेंट एट जीएमसी नागपुर, एंड थैंक यू सो मच फॉर बीइंग हियर। बिफोर वी एक्चुअली बिगिन, लेट मी जस्ट टेल यू अ फ्यू लिटिल थिंग्स। This, the way our system works is that we are trained like machines. From 9, 10th, 11th, 12th standard, we are told that you have to work, and then you will get a particular college. And if you graduate from that college, you will definitely get a better placement and you'll earn better money. This is all what we have been always told. But if you look at the top 50 people or top 500 people in the world, the main source of their income does not come from them being employed, as in contrary to what we are always taught. Usually, when a father tells his son that, beta, you have to work a lot, you have to study a lot, and tabhi tum jaake ek successful insaan ban sakte ho, and only then will you be able to achieve something in life and earn some money. Now, that is completely right. I agree with that point that education is the utmost important thing in the world. But while you are educating yourself, I think every student should be able to make some money out of doing some part-time things. So, without further ado, let us see how you can make money as a student. I am your host, Anuj Pachhel, second year MBBS from GMC Nagpur. So, there's this really good book called as Rich Dad and Poor Dad. And in that really good book, there's an analogy of what the poor dad tells his kids to do and what the rich dad tells his kids to do. It also talks about the four quadrant system, wherein he tells us that there are only four ways in which you can generate income. The first one is the self-employment, second one is employment, third one is business, and the fourth one is investment. Now the first two which I talked about, employment and self-employment, these are not the things that you should be going into. These are actually the things that you should be giving to people. Like employment, you should be the provider rather than the employee. The thing what matters over here is that the self-employment as well as employment, both of these things require active work to be done for active income. Otherwise, when you stop working, the amount of money that you will be receiving will definitely fall down. Whereas in compared to your business or your investment, here active work and the active amount of time you spend doing a particular thing does not guarantee money. It may happen that you may not even work and your bank accounts will get filled with lakhs of rupees. And we will tackle the four quadrants in this video, and each quadrant will focus on how you can make money as a student. So let us start with our first quadrant, which is self-employment. As it states that you are self-employed. Now as a student, there are many websites which visit. You can enlist yourself as a person who is having a particular skill. For example, you are really good at video editing or photo editing or doing some errands. Then you can go on websites like Fiverr and other websites which you can see over here and enlist yourself. Now what this will do is that other people who are looking for the same job, let's say I am a big CEO of a big company and I want a PPT presentation made from you and I have found nobody else, so I went on Fiverr and I chose you as the one who is going to make my PPT. Being the rich guy that I am, I will pay you some amount of money to make that PPT for me. So you, while being at home, will be able to make money through your skills. You can enlist any number of skills over there, something like coding, making a website, app development, video editing, photo editing, document presentation, document making, everything. The only thing is that you will have to put in some amount of work over here before you can actually get ahead. The way that once you get your first client and they give you a 5-star rating, then things start rolling. Because now everybody will see you as a person who has got 5-star rating and everybody will want you. And gradually you can increase your prices so that some people make even hundreds of dollars working for a single project. And that can be you. So as a student, self-employment is the best way practiced in this website. Other ways, in offline modes, you can be self-employed, you can do some errands around locality and you can earn money in that way also. Again, I would tell you that self-employment and employment are not the places that you want to be in the first place. Now let us talk about our second quadrant. The second quadrant is actually about employment. Now employment, it means that somebody is employing you and giving you money to do some job on a particular basis. Again, you have to take a piece of paper and write down what are the different skills that you know. If you don't have any skills, then definitely build some skills and then use them to get employed for a particular employer. Let us say that I'm very good at video editing. I will email different people asking them for a job. And this is what looking for a job actually feels like. You have to work hard and then you will get employed by a certain amount, a certain company or a certain individual. Once you have your list of skills, let's say video editing, photo editing, marketing, one-on-one promotion. Now, one-on-one promotion is very important because as a medical student, there are different, you know, big institutions which pay you for promoting their educational brands. Let's say that you topped very nicely from your institution XYZ while you are preparing for NEET. Now you can become a member of their marketing team, the same institution, and help promote that institution in different places. Let's say that you have joined some coaching for NEET, PG or NEXT. You can become a member of that coaching as a marketing, you know, helper, and you can market their product or service to different people. So again, one-on-one marketing is good. Apart from that, you can also be employed, like I told you, as a personal assistant to some of the big people that you might know. For example, I get emails every single day from people asking me to get employed under me and become like personal assistants or people who will manage my social handles, etc. Speaking on social handles, you can also start your own thing by becoming a social media marketing professionalist. Now, what does that mean? Let's say that I have a company which sells cookies. Now I have a website for that cookie selling thing. So everybody who visits my websites, I feel like should receive an advertisement of my website on Instagram so that I could have more customer acquisition. For that reason, I need to have a very beautiful set of photos which I can upload as promotional stories. I should know how Instagram promotion, how Facebook promotion works. So if you can educate yourself in the same thing, then that would be very beneficial because then you can apply for different things and you will get selected. The easiest way to do this, however, is going on apps like LinkedIn, or you can just search Google for jobs on your basis, and that will give you the list of jobs which are present in your locality and outside your locality. So I guess that was all about employment. Now let us start talking about business. This is the third quadrant, and I feel like everybody should be in this third quadrant itself. Maybe you are not employed or not self-employed, but business, absolutely everyone should start. The reason is, when we are in college, we have a safety net that even if our business fails, nothing can happen to us. And it will take a fair amount of trying before your business actually succeeds. Unless you are like a very popular person, then your business will succeed right away. So what are the different skills that you have? I'll talk about myself. I love teaching people in the first place, and that's one of the reasons that I started this channel. So my skill was to teach people, and I kind of turned that into a business. How did I do that? The first thing is that I recorded my lectures as a digital, copy, and then just made an app and put those lectures in that app. And now that app is loved by thousands of people, and every single day, that app runs itself. So that is the thing. Know your skills and monetize them. One of the best things that a student can do to start his own business is by simply selling the notes which they have prepared. It will take some amount of time initially, but later it will pay off for itself. Let's say that you have taken out beautiful notes of CNS in physiology. Now CNS is a difficult topic, and everybody would love to read the notes which are simplified and from a student's point of view, so that they could also learn what you have learned. You can easily type out your notes in a span of a month, even if you're a slow typer, and then that type notes could be easily turned into a book which you can sell. Publishing a book does not require a lot of things. You can self-publish it if you don't have any sort of resources with you. Just make a PDF, make everything yours, and then just print it out from a bulk producer, and then just sell it to different people. The way you can sell it is by making a website or by directly selling those books to yourself. I have a friend of mine who actually makes very beautiful digital artwork. So these are like very nice diagrams she makes on her iPad. And then what she does is that she sells that for a particular amount of money as posters. So you can see that any skill which you can think of can be easily monetized. And that is the thing. And business is by far the best way for us. The reason is that it is something in which we don't have to put active amount of work. Once you have put in some amount of work, it is done for. Then you don't have to look for it again. हमें बचपन से बताया जाता है कि business करना is for बड़े लोग. Businessman अमीर होते हैं. And we are always told that जो employee होते हैं, वो गरीब होते हैं. And that is very very true. But still, everybody trains for becoming an employee and nobody trains for becoming a businessman. So you, my dear friend, just write down whatever the skills you have. Maybe you are good at teaching. Start your own business by teaching a group of people. Start your own app in which you have recorded lectures. Sell your own digital products. Unless and until you don't start this, you won't really get to see the magic of it. Coming to our last quadrant, it is called as investment. Now, investment is a very big topic in itself. And as a student, what I've experienced is that us students don't even have the money to start investing into stuff. So I think that investment deserves its own separate video, so I'm not talking about it here. However, if you like this video and if this video really works well, then I'll definitely make a video where I'll talk about the different sources from which you can give money, and that money will run for itself and make money for itself. A simple, very simple example is a compound interest that you get when you have a bank account. So let's say a bank account, you have some kind of account, let's say a FD or a PPF. Now you deposit that money and that money will earn some money, and then that cumulative thing will again get some interest and it will keep running and you will keep adding more money to it. So it kind of generates a passive thing for you. There is also the stock market, which basically, you know, talks about you can buy a part of a one company for a particular amount of money and then you can sell it for a higher price in order to get like double or triple amounts of money that you have already invested. So tumne video to dekh liya, ab kya karna hai tumko at a personal level? The simple thing is that take a piece of paper and write down all the different skills that you have. Now I highly suggest that if you're an 11th and 12th standard student, please don't get into this. Study a lot, get into a medical college or a different college which you want to be, and then start doing things that you want to do. But for college students, it is an absolute must. Basically, take a piece of paper, write down all the different skills that you have, and then think in which way can you use those skills to get into the three basic quadrants which I talked about: employment, self-employment, and business. And definitely, if you think for one day, you will find a lot of opportunities, a lot of different roads in which you can go on. Apart from that, kindly read the description. There are several different links of different websites which will actually help you make some amount of money. I've also mentioned some blog articles which I really really enjoyed in the process of researching for this video. So yeah, that was all for today's video, and if this video added some value to your life and if you're now more motivated towards your target, please hit that like button. It gives me a lot of motivation to continue making videos such as this. Also, if you want a part 2 on investment, kindly let me know down below in the comments, because I read all of them. And yeah, with that being said, take a look at all the different videos on this channel, and if you like them, please kindly do subscribe. It means a lot. Chalo, with that being said, as always, stay safe, stay healthy, and stay happy, my dear friends. Until next time, I'll see you soon.